Hi there. In this video, we are going to be unboxing Lenovo Gaming IdeaPad 3 laptop. Don't confuse it with Lenovo IdeaPad 3. If it doesn't have the gaming in the name, it's not the same thing. If that's not confusing, I don't know what it is. Anyway, good were the days when laptops had simple numbers as a reference to what it actually is and what it can do. So, at this point we will also be installing Windows 11 onto it. So you can think of at this video as what you are expecting when you buy one of these without a Windows license. I bought a Windows license online and we will be installing it onto this thing. My unboxing tool. Hey, if it works, it ain't stupid or something on those lines. Bought this thing on Black Friday from PC Garage, and it was cheaper a few days later on another site. So that's fun, but on the other side, you basically couldn't buy it because something wasn't working right. So I remained with this one, which was a bit more expensive. Needed to cut the video for a second because there was a sheet directly on top of this with all the data on it. And here we are. As a bonus, I also got a gaming mat, which I will show you in a second, and then get back to the laptop. Come on, mat. And I'm showing you just because it has something to do with this particular laptop. It's not just a random gaming mat. AMD Ryzen, Jesus. Nice backing to it. Yep, I like it. Gaming evolved. Okay, let's put this aside. AMD. Cool. And let's get this little laptop out of the box. Decently heavy. And let's see, where do we open this thing? Presumably right here. We have a Lenovo sticker. So in theory, we know that we are the first ones entering this box, which is what you always want. Not really. Okay, we have the laptop here, and okay, as you can see here, this is for a laptop hard drive, a flex cable and a connector and some screws. So this is for upgrade. We will be also using this in a future video because we will be also upgrading this thing. So stay tuned to that. Charger. This is a big one. This is quite a big brick. How big is it? How many amps does it have? Ooh, 6.75 amps at 20 volts. So that's 135 watts. That's a lot. This is a nice brick. And the standard newer Lenovo connector, which I like and don't have absolutely any issue with it. Although some don't seem to like the square shape, rectangular shape actually. And the cable with EU plug on it. Nothing special about that. Some documentation. I mean, honestly, not much. Safety and warranty guide. Don't care about that for the moment. Setup guide. OK. Case. Yeah, so plug it into the wall, power it on. It's showing you everything, all the ports, the cooling and whatnot. If you want to read it. Different languages, so this might be useful for us. Okay, put that aside and let's get to the laptop itself. I like this type of packaging, honestly. Better than the white stuff that gets everywhere in case you damage it by mistake. Let's see, shiny outside, but not really prone to fingerprints. That's something that I like. It's heavy. I will say it's heavy. It's not a light laptop. And it's not also a thin one. But not extremely thick anyway. IdeaPad gaming right here text. So let's see. This little Lenovo logo that I quite like in here. The shape I honestly really like. As you can see, it's not just a rectangular laptop. It has these chamfers. So let's move the camera and it will squeak like a really professional one should do. Come on, get that out of the way. And we are in here. Ta-da! And we need to zoom out a tiny bit because we cannot get this whole thing in. Oh, Jesus, let me show you. Okay, first impression, many stickers. I kind of hate stickers, so they will be coming off. Although, in the sticker world, these two, at least the AMD ones, are quite interesting with some holographic 3D stuff on them. Nvidia one, basic. Game ready, yeah, why? Yeah. IPS display, yes, high performance thermals will be the judge of that in time. I really love the fact that it has full size arrow keys on it. Perfect. Keyboard, honestly, what I would expect from a Lenovo at this point in time. Doesn't seem to flex that much. What you see here, movement, it's just because of this rug underneath it. And a tiny bit of flex, but nothing important. This trackpad, touchpad, decently big. It has this thing right here, which I really like. The fact that you can basically shut off the camera just by pulling onto a thing right here. Yes, we need to first remove the sticker. Do-do-do. And now, on the inside, so not above the glass, we have a physical cover for the camera. So when that's closed, nobody can see you, whatever they do. And that's about it. Let's see what else. I don't think there's much because, again, I will tell you more about this laptop as I work with it in future videos when I will show you how to upgrade it. And one of the reasons that I got it's really cheap for what it is. I honestly couldn't find a better alternative. It's a Ryzen 7 4800H. It has 8 gigs of RAM, 256 gigs of SSD. For the moment, I will be upgrading in the really close future the storage and the memory, maybe in a bit but distant, a more distant future. Not really sure for the memory, but storage for 100%, and this can be upgraded a lot. So that's a bonus. In my opinion, get one with a powerful CPU. And presumably GPU. You can also get it now, I think, with a RTX 3050 4 gig card. This is also 4 gig, but it's a 16 16 I cannot really talk 1650 50. So this is an older card, but for what I'm doing, more than enough. Anyway, quite happy about this thing, and it's upgradable a lot. So don't go for big storage, big RAM, go for better CPU and better GPU, and you can add to the memory and the storage in the future extremely simple in this particular laptop. So there's that. At this point in time, I will plug it in, and and this can, as you can see, can be opened up really nicely even by the corner. It does flex a little, but nothing dramatic, so I like that, although I recommend you open it from the center always. But yeah, just wanted to say. And yes, the keyboard is illuminated, which again I really like. I love illuminated keyboards, couldn't live without one. So let's plug it in and get to installing Windows 11. Let's power it on for the first time. I don't recommend you use it on a carpet like this. This will be done just briefly, and then I won't do it again, obviously, but for the moment I'm power it on a carpet. It showed the Lenovo logo for a moment, and now it's checking to see if it has anything to boot from, and it won't have anything to boot from. And that is why, yeah, we have, I think, 3 DOS enter date. Old MS-DOS days. So it's basically nothing on this laptop. I have a Windows 11 install kit, and I will show you next how to create this thing on a working laptop. And now that you saw how to create it, shut this thing right back off and plug it onto a USB port of your choosing. Is there a USB port on this side? Yes, there is. Power it on, and in theory, because it doesn't have an OS on it, it will probably directly boot from that bootable drive. But I will also link in the description a video that shows you how to boot from anything that other device that you need on Lenovo laptops. But for the moment, presumably you can see some light in there. So Windows 11 setup is actually loading. Now, language English, that's good. With tab we can move, or with the mouse. Romanian. Keyboard input, I think we are with US. United States International, as far as I'm aware. And next. And install now. From this point on, I will zoom more towards the screen itself. If you have a key, and you should have a Windows 11 key, if you didn't have Windows 10 at any point in time installed on it, and you didn't because we are presumably working with a new one, because Windows 11 can use the key from an old Windows 10 install that you have in the BIOS or saved on Microsoft servers, whatnot. Whatever. If you have the key, you bought a key, put it in here now and click on next. Dumb as me, actually bought a Windows 10 key, so I will install Windows 11 now because I started to show you how, and later I will make a separate video to show how to install Windows 10 because I need to activate it with the key that I bought and then upgrade to Windows 11. So I don't have a product key, and you can honestly, you can use Windows 11 without a product key without absolutely any problem. So Windows 11 Pro, it will just not allow you to change, I think, your Teams, your desktop background and stuff like that, which honestly is not a big deal at all, in my opinion. Install Windows only because it's a new laptop. Come on. As you can see here, unallocated space. I will not create a second partition because this is a small SSD. I will leave everything to Windows. So, new. Apply. Okay. Okay-ish. Show details. What? Okay. So out of the box, it comes with a master boot record instead of GPT that Windows 11 wants. So we go to this one. Presumably it has some recovery stuff from Lenovo. I couldn't care less about that, honestly. If you care about stuff like that, then don't delete it, but I don't, so I delete it. Now we don't have any partition, and when we click new, it will do all that it needs, and then we will be able to install it. As you can see, it created its own things, and now on partition number 3, hit next, and voila, Windows 11 install is going, hopefully quite quickly, but my USB drive that I plugged in, it's USB 2, so it's not slow, it's really, really slow. Be back to you when this finishes. Something else that I want to tell you while it's copying files, actually finished copying. I'm not going to show you it has this port in here, it has that port in there, blah, 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 blah. There are plenty of videos showing you that online. What I'm going to show to tell you actually why I bought this particular one after playing with hundreds of laptops on my channel. It has decently thin borders, so I'm not wasting a lot of space in my luggage. Yes, it's thin, but in the particular luggage that I will put this in, this direction is more important than how thin it is. So that's the first thing. Then I fully wanted an IPS display. That was, I wouldn't get anything except IPS. It has a bit of light bleed, as you can see here and here and here, and I don't particularly like that, but yeah, all of them have it to an extent. More expensive ones, obviously less. Another thing, I wanted this to have USB 3, which it obviously does. I wanted it to have HDMI, it does. Wanted it to have a keyboard with also numpad, I think, area. A decently big trackpad, it has it. Full-size arrows that I showed you on the keyboard, it has them. And basically the rest of it, cheap in price, decent GPU, decent CPU, and upgradability to the max. And upgradability in this laptop is to the max that you can expect from a laptop in this period of time. And also the fact that it has that cover on the camera, that was a bonus. Illuminated keyboard, forgot to tell you about that. That was a must, so I love that it has it. It will squeak once again, this thing. You can see, or can you not see? Where do I turn on the light? Presumably function and space. And now you can start to see it at different intensity levels. So this is really low. I can see it already here. And this is maybe in some circumstances a bit too much. This is enough. So that thing was also a must. A big charger, so it can handle it working at maximum capacity without extremely overheating the charger, I mean, or discharging the batteries. There are laptops that when you work them really hard actually end up discharging your battery, if you can believe that. This will not be the case with this laptop. And I couldn't find anybody online saying something extremely bad about this laptop, something really bad from its design or configuration. All reviews was good for the price. Well, for the price, I also think it's good. And I do have a soft spot for Lenovo's, so there's that. Let's see. On the, where is NumLock? We have, yeah, we even have lights on NumLock and Caps Lock. That's becoming, and you have function lock also. Oh, that's, wait, what? How do I get function lock to work? I was expecting it to work like pressing function or something. Well, don't know how to say to do that anyway. But you rarely and rarely you find touches like this. Anyway, the newer models, the ones with RTX 3050 have how do you call them? RGB keyboards. So that's nice, but they were way more expensive. About, sorry about the squeaking, about at least $200 more than this one. So hit enter and continue with the install. It fully forgot about the layout, which I kind of hate about Windows 11 at the moment, but they will probably fix this thing. Yes. No secondary keyboard layout. And I will connect it to a network and click on next. At this point in time, simply click next. It will check for updates. Presumably it will find, because Windows always finds updates somehow, even if it's a freshly created bootable drive, it still finds updates. So be back to you when something happens. Name your laptop. R7 will go for me from Ryzen 7. I always name laptops based on the CPU. The display is not extremely bright, but it's brighter than many old laptops that I get to play on this channel. So for me, that's a non-issue. And this that you see, the light bleed, is much less obvious in person than you see it on camera. Camera has a tendency to accentuate defects in displays. As you can see, I cannot even properly focus on this text right in the middle, although I can see it perfectly with my own eyes. And you can see how bright it is when the background fully disappears what's around the laptop. Bright enough, in my opinion, for most things. Yes, probably not for gaming in full daylight outside. Personally, I don't do that, so I don't care. Personal use. Next. No. Sign in options. Offline account. I don't want an online account. Skip for now. And my name. Ha, you know it. I was thinking what name to use, and this would suit best. Not setting up a password at this point in time will be done in the future. And now I will use a bunch of no's, although, as I say in all my videos, we accept these things, honestly, on all other devices, on Android, on Apple phones. They track us everywhere. We let Facebook track us everywhere. We let cameras put a location in the data of the picture. But we don't let Microsoft do the same thing, which is a bit weird, but everybody does it, so somehow it's in me, and I also do it, although I understand and I know that I shouldn't do it, but I click on no for everything, so there's that. This thing is continuing. For noise, although I've put it down on this, on the rug, it's still not extremely noisy. Actually, it's quite quiet, honestly. Even if it cannot really take air as it should be. And in theory, you shouldn't use your laptop like this. Put it on solid surfaces so it can draw air easily from underneath. But even like this, even installing Windows, it's decently quiet. And the noise that it makes, it's not a high-pitched whining noise. It's just air moving. So good enough, in my opinion. Be back to you when this whole thing finishes. Which will be quite soon, honestly. And we are booted right into Windows 11. And I think it's finding drivers as we speak, which is great. Let me go to control panel and see exactly what drivers are installed and what will it install by itself. Okay, so it doesn't have yet installed for video and three other things, which honestly, for a fresh install, it's quite good. I'm used to seeing a bunch of uninstalled drivers, and for sure it will install at least for these two, maybe for the others. So we need to let it do its thing. We can hurry it up just a tiny bit with a particular one, let's say like that. If we go to update driver, search automatically, and go to search for updated drivers or on Windows Update. And now we kind of force it to look everywhere, but again, it will still search by itself. And you can see here AMD display, Lenovo system, Realtek for internet, AMD for security devices. This is a new laptop, and these things will most likely be all of them, all the drivers installed automatically from the web on Windows 11, which is awesome. So let it do its thing and get back to you when it finishes. Continuing the install, and I just love to see all of these cores and threads at work. If you want to have this view, simply right click in here. Where is my touchpad? Cannot find it. And go to change graph to logical processors. It normally comes with overall. This is really fun to watch. So we already have both GPUs. We have the GeForce GTX 1650 4 gig, and we have the integrated Radeon from the CPU. Best of both worlds. This one consumes not a lot of power at all. This one a bit more power, but only when you actually need it. So that's awesome in my opinion. And up until now, this thing is flying through all the updates and whatever it's doing, it's flying. Honestly, I really like it. We are back and all the drivers are installed. I basically just sat on my ass right next to it and wait for it to do all the heavy lifting. I love how modern operating systems are able to do this themselves, honestly. So that is awesome. You can see here both GPUs, obviously. And I had just a tiny bit of sound coming from this thing when it powered on. And let's see, sound somewhere anyway. Come on. The way it sounds is much better compared to what I was expecting. Obviously, I will tell you in the future videos what I think about this when I use it. But for the moment, again, I didn't see absolutely any downside to this laptop. So I rarely am able to say that. If you watch my videos, I always complain about something. For the moment, I didn't find anything to complain about. Presumably, I will find in the future. Also like the colors of the display, honestly. Maybe this blue helps, who knows, but I like it. So that's about it for this first video with this particular laptop. Future videos will be way more in depth. This was just what you get when you buy this laptop, take it home, put Windows 11 on it, and have a ready-to-go laptop. That was all the purpose, and just small presentation of some reason that I bought it this instead of other laptops. Hope I made it clear and it was okay. And yeah, that's about it for the video. And as always, feel free to ask in the comments. I always try to answer. Check out my other videos, subscribe, and see you in the next one. Bye.